And what about Leo, Alpha Alpha 4 Mike Mike, what's up with him?
I've no idea at all, nobody's heard him on that day. I think I ought to phone him up. That's same here. That's very, very unusual.
I hope he's okay.
Yeah, I feel sorry for those purple-haired ladies that he hangs around with. When he had his new heart, oh boy, they were nervous, I tell you.
Well, when
you get them purple, that's right. You know, Leo used to do his own housework, so when the house, the domestic ladies used to come in, they'd have more time for him, John.
Oh, really?
Well, that's what he'd do. Well, he told me he used to do the, used to do the cleanup before they came.
That's funny.
WJ. 22, what's 22, guy?
21.
Oh, it's, actual winter summertime is 3:22 here. No, leave it alone, glue it, leave it alone, guy.
Well, just trying to get you upset.
Yeah. And there was me, I was hoping to bore you to death with the adjustments, and you bored me to death with the adjustments. You've outlasted me.
How are you? Just inside, man.
Oh, Ed, where you been?
I've been busy, working on design for, Alex.
Ooh, how tall?
Oh, not much, 50 feet. Just enough to get my hex beam, kind of sitting in the backyard.
That sounds good.
Yeah, I don't want to put it near this 40-meter beam. I'm afraid it's going to detune it.
Yeah. You might be right.
Yeah, I've got the beam is at 40 feet, and I've got 8 foot of mast above it, so I think I'm just going to stick my 6-meter Yagi and a 2-meter J-pole on top, and then I'll put the hex beam on the 60-foot tower.
Oh, that sounds like a nice installation. Call, 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 Ned.
How you doing, 12-0 with Selima? How are you? It's a little noisy tonight here, but you're about a 5-8, I think.